core business before I started milling was tree surgery and firewood sales. Having taken down, you know, some fantastic trees, which I just thought was a complete sacrilege to turn into firewood and create great value out of milled timber. So I looked at a lot of different mills and thought, for the trees I'm taking down, the way this machine, you can get through small gaps in small gardens, set it around the log. You don't need huge timber handling machinery in order to deal with huge bits of timber, then this was the perfect machine to go for. Well, actually, most of my work has just been sort of recommendation, word of mouth, and I haven't actually advertised it yet, but just with recommendations from estates and stuff that I've done, I've actually been on average probably 3 or 4 days a month milling with this, which isn't bad considering I've still got my tree surgery and firewood business to do, and then obviously all milling for timber for my own personal use, for my own building projects and furniture and stuff for myself. Again, I charge a day rate for the milling, which is, you know, comparable to a day rate that I charge for tree surgery, one place set up. It's good money. The most common work is something similar to this, where a customer has a tree come down, and again, it's, you know, a nice big tree, and they've got ideas of building stuff for themselves in order to make furniture for the house or building projects. As a bit of an idea of taking timber from their own tree and using it. It's not, the tree hasn't come down just for the sake of coming down then, it lives on. Angle brackets up to 10 inch by 10 inch, even complete troughs for if you want to completely enclose RSJs within buildings. It's a bit more work and a bit more messy, but it's a really good machine. It's a very versatile machine. I haven't yet got the slabbing attachment, but I think that will be one for the future in order, you know, for making tabletops out of stuff like this. I mean, it'd be an incredible table, wouldn't it? I think the main strengths of this mill are the fact that it's so versatile and portable. If we have a huge tree down where access is tight, where you can't get a big machine to get a big tree out of the woods, then you can take the mill to the tree, and then that can come out in smaller bits on a, you know, compact tractor or whatever. So just the fact that it was set up in the back garden, it cut, you know, massive timbers, bigger timbers than generally necessary, up to 10 inch by 20 inch timbers can be cut. If you was considering one, how much big timber are you taking down? Have you got contacts to, you know, estates or estate work? But it's introduced, it's opened up quite a lot of doors for me, and I've actually been now all over the country with this machine, milling for varying different people. So I think it's a fantastic piece of kit to have.